Do you remember when you were a kid, your mother would lean over you and say things like, eat it, it's good for you. You know I ate cabbage. Eat it, it'll do you good, it's full of iron. I don't want to go rusty. Eat it, cabbage is wonderful for growing children. You know the difference between cabbage and snot, by the way? Kids will eat snot. Eat it, I don't want it. Never mind what you want, if you don't eat it, it'll be there for your breakfast and for your dinner and for your tea tomorrow night as well. It's good for you. Do you remember those immortal words your mother would say as she battered you around the head? It's good for you. What can you say that about nowadays? Bugger all, basically. Don't eat it, it'll kill you. I'm starving, Mum, I'm starving. Here, suck this ball bearing, you'll feel a lot better. We're poisoning ourselves. The supermarket shelves are full of dye stuffs, poisons, monosodium glutamate, E numbers, permitted colorants, artificial preservatives. ICI make half the food we eat. And the rest of it on the high street is killing you. All these fast food outlets, that's terrible. It's junk, all that stuff. This is the way the world ends, not with a bang, but a wimpy. I'll tell you something, McDonald's are gonna sue me before I finish the tour. They're definitely gonna sue me, but this is true. Have you ever noticed when you go into a McDonald's, you never see anybody cooking anything? Not a frying pan for miles, no chance. There's all these people in clone-type uniforms all going, £4.50, have a nice day. £7.20, have a nice day. £3.15, have a nice day. No. You never see anybody cooking anything because round the back there's a secret room that only the initiate and the learned are allowed into. And in the middle of that room, there's just one big pipe and everything comes out of that one pipe. It's got different nozzles on it, but it all comes out of the one pipe. Burger, fries, milkshake, and it's all made from dog's lips. Did you read? Death on bread. Did you read in the papers? Come on, you must have read in the papers. McDonald's actually admitted that we do put filler in our milkshakes. They do. Polyfiller. The stuff has got the consistency of the sludge you get out of the bottom of rowing boats at the end of a summer. And they give you a piddling little straw to suck it out with. And you're sat on those green plastic chairs that are like incontinence pants. And you suck that hard, you create a total vacuum in your body. And your ass sticks to the seat like a limpet. They've got special wedges in there to get people off, you know, and knock them in. Even the pubs have got junk food now. You go to a pub now and they're advertising the dentist friend, pork scratchings. We went in this pub today, and it's got pork scratchings, and it's got a competition. They're made in Otley, these scratchings, or something like that. And it's got a spot the nipple competition. There's a pig's nipple in every 500th packet. And if you find it, you get a fortnight's holiday in Otley. Whoever invented those? Some genius. The only bit of the pig that nobody wants, and he finds something to do with it. I think that's brilliant. I mean, I reckon it was some old Dale's farmer up Garsdale or somewhere like that, or Ribblesdale. I said, Mavis, hey, this pig's got terrible dermatitis. Just a minute, I've got an idea. Get me a frying pan and a mallet. Well, the pubs are poisoning us now, not with junk beer, I mean, but junk food as well. You go in. And they're advertising in some of the country pubs now, which have gone very upmarket and tried to become like sort of roadhouses and sort of invite people out there and get you out there for lunch and things like that. The basket meals, I've noticed over the years, have been going very much upmarket. At one time, it was just like chicken and chips in the basket or Cumberland sausage and chips in the basket. We had this place on the moors coming over from Halifax, and there's this wonderful pub there, Shoulder and Mutton, I think it's called, and they're gone really upmarket, you know, sort of right posh it, isn't it? Paper in the gents, I mean, how posh can you get? And they've got frog's legs, prawn balls in the basket. That's me on the deck. Frog's legs and prawn balls in the basket. I'm crawling around laughing. So I've got a sudden mental image of the prawns meeting the frogs on Manningham Lane one afternoon. And the frogs are on little trolleys with tiny wheels and sticks pushing themselves along. And the prawns look down and say, oh, they cut your legs off. I mean, everybody knows that prawns normally say, hi, how are you doing? Check it out, man. Get down there. But even your friends kill you without realizing it. You know this, your friends don't mean to do it, but even they are killing you bit by bit. You go around to a party at a friend's house like I did this Christmas, and there's all this stuff from the supermarket there, and it's all full of additives and stuff, all these sort of nibbles that you've got. And I've got to admit, this was my fault. I was totally and absolutely gone. The St. Christopher medal had got off and said, you're on your own now, pal, I'm going. Because I went in, I was steaming. And I ate 6 grapefruits wrapped in baker foil. I had to take all these sticks off with bits of cheese and pickle on them and things like that, you know. I don't know what they were doing there. And then I worked my way along the table and I got to these Twiglets. Now, I've got to tell you, I am a Twiglet monster. I will kill for Twiglets. I love them. And I ate 500 of these Twiglets out of this sort of glass bowl, like 500 of them. This little boy said, Dad, that bloke with the glasses has just eaten all my stick insects. Him on the end there. It tasted all right, actually. I'm going to try them as a party dish with some dips. They could be all right. I don't know. They tasted all right to me.